Well, welcome back to the studio. I'm going to be painting this horse on the left now. You had seen me sketch him in at the beginning of this painting, and now I'm going to start doing the opaque paint on him. I've shown my reference picture in the very beginning of the video. I'm changing I have changed his legs to a different stage of his stride in running through the water. First, I'm going to do his tail. And it's pretty much in shadow because the light is coming in from the right. And I just pull this over the paint in the background. There will be a little bit of light just catching the very top of his tail. And I'm going to use a little bit of white with some ultramarine blue mixed in because I don't want this white to be so bright that it pops forward of the rest of his body. Oops. I don't like that little brush stroke. So I have saved some of my background color. I can just come in and paint that out. That's the nice thing about oil paints. Is these paints will stay on my canvas for several days, or on my palette for several days where I can use them. Even if they develop a little skin over the top of them, I can still just kind of poke down into the pile of color and pull out some usable color. So again, that's not quite light enough on the top of his tail. I'm going to add a little bit more white to that mixture. So I want that highlight to be there, but not come forward of the rest of the horse, so I cool it down. Cool colors recede, warm colors come forward. I've got that there. I'm not going to worry about it right now. If I have to come back and lighten it a little bit, I will. Now his hips, I'm using a little bit of warmer white for the light hitting his hips. And I'm using mixtures of white plus a little bit of my mud, which is ultramarine blue plus alizarin crimson. And then I've added some little more ultramarine blue into that and a little bit of cadmium orange. That just gives me a nice gray. And then like this mixture has a little bit more blue in it and not as much of the cadmium orange. So I use several variations. This leg, his back legs pretty much get lost in the splashing of the water. This leg back here is going to be a little darker. It just goes back behind. But again, there's really not much there that you see because the water's all splashing up. And I'll work those splashes in a little bit more once I get a little bit further along. His stifle joint here gets a little bit of a highlight on it, as his hip up here. I like using a bright brush. This is a square brush. I can use the flat side for covering large areas, but then if I need to, I can use the corner for details. Like here, I'm using the corner of the brush to pull my light down. His head and neck cast a shadow over the front part of his back there, but the light pours over then his hips. So this shadow comes around. And I keep cleaning my brush. The secret to clean paint, clean crisp colors on your canvas is a clean brush. Now I'm using a little highlight here. Again, now I'm using a little bit cooler mixture. I want that top part to be lighter, but then as it comes over his back, that'll be cooler and disappear into shadow. I can just use the brush then to soften that down. Now I'm going to use just a mixture of ultramarine blue plus white Just give me a little bit of coolness right here where that shadow comes over. Now his barrel is going to be darker in here. And this is again a darker mixture of my white plus a little bit of mud plus ultramarine blue plus a tiny bit of cadmium orange. You can see I've used several variations of this mixture to make all the different values that I need for the horse. Some are warmer with more orange, some are cooler with more blue in them. Like this is a little bit warmer. This has a little bit more of the cadmium orange in it. So as I move forward on the horse, I want the mixtures to be a little bit warmer. Now, I painted the mane in another session because I really wanted to do it while the trees were good and wet. So it's easier to pull that nice flow of the mane into the wet paint. Now I'm going to have a little bit of shadow, or make this a little bit darker on his back side of this back leg. And I'm using ultramarine blue plus white, a little darker mixture. And this just makes that form rounded. Now I come back and clean my brush. I use this to soften that transition. Again, that stifle joint's a little bit lighter. It's a little bit too light, but again, I can just soften that transition and make that work. I'm going to come back in here and make this a little bit darker, this other back leg, just to give a little bit of definition. Smooth that a little bit and soften this edge so it's not so hard. Now the underneath side of his barrel is going to reflect the light of the water, that blue, cool blue. So I'm using a mixture of my white plus ultramarine blue. May have to make that a little bit darker so it stands out from the water underneath, but yeah, make that a little bit darker. But his belly's going to be blue. This helps round his belly. And he's reflecting that coolness of the water underneath him. And then I come back and I can just... He's kind of got some dapples here that where the water has come up and darkened his skin. White horses usually have a dark skin a lot of times. And so when they get wet, it gets darker. Come in here and make that, don't go like that. Make that a little more anatomically correct. Now this is a little bit hard right there, so I can just take my brush and make that a little bit softer. Now the light on his chest here, the sun, this is a mixture, it's a warm mixture of my white plus a little cadmium orange plus a little bit of ultramarine blue. I'm not using pure white here. I'm only going to use pure white for the highlights. This comes down his chest. Now I'm going to throw a little bit of blue up onto this side of his shoulder, because that's reflecting up from the water. point of his shoulder catches that light that's coming under his neck. I want to soften this transition between the dark part here and the shadow and the light part of his neck. Bring this here. Clean my brush. And I just soften that edge. Now I'm taking some pure white because the point of his shoulder is more prominent, so that catches a little more light, and then his neck catches a little more light along there. Now back here I'm going to make this highlight with my white plus ultramarine blue because I want this shoulder to go back, and that's a little bit dark, so I can add a little light into that. But we want that shoulder, the highlight on it, to be a little bit cooler so that it'll go back. I can just, where this other horse is, went over a little bit. Just soften that. He's going to be darker. And here, where this leg comes forward, and then this is his back leg back there. His chest goes underneath. And these muscles here come around. Painting his legs, I'm using ivory black, on his knee and lower leg because I want those legs to stand out from the water. He's really stretched out right here. Make his hoof. His hoof's going to be a little warmer gray. It's because a horse has black legs. Their hooves are not usually black. If you see a horse in show, a lot of times they'll use shoe polish to make their hooves black, but they're not natural. Usually they're not black. Well, there's always exceptions to the rule, but. Now my water's still wet, so I can just pull that here. And I'm going to make the back of his hoof a little bit darker. And then I'm going to highlight the front edge of his hoof, just so it comes out from the water. Soften the back edge of his front leg. Again, this is still wet behind him. So I can pull up some of that, my splashing watercolor back here. I just want that transition right there smooth, or softened, not smooth, softened. So the sharp edges of his legs come forward and that water is soft so it goes back. Now I'm using ultramarine blue plus white for the highlights on his leg, on his front leg. And then this dark works up into his foreleg. Usually along that muscle, it's usually a little bit darker. Oops, I didn't mean that brush stroke to jump in there. Sometimes you inadvertently hit the canvas, and that's easy enough to just paint out. This slope of his shoulder is going to be a little bit lighter in here. That plane. I'm going to bring a little bit of my ultramarine blue plus white in here, just again, reflected light from that water underneath. And then the light's going to hit his foreleg here. Soften this edge of that shadow so it rounds his leg. Okay. I really appreciate you watching my videos. Please subscribe to my channel, my YouTube channel. I also have a blog where I show the complete step-by-step process of my paintings. The address is in the description below, and it's also on the final frame of my blog, or of my video. Again, I appreciate you following along, and I will show the head, painting his head in a separate video. So I hope you come and watch. And thank you again.